Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome back to Dark Python Plays Dungeon Defenders 2. And this is the Halloween update, the spookiest update in the world. How's everyone doing? I am Dark Python, and we are back playing Dungeon Defenders 2. It is the Halloween update. And yeah, we're just going to be playing this. Happy Halloween to all of those in America and other countries who actually bother with this this holiday. Not really a huge thing over here in Britain, so yeah, we got that going for us. So I got a hair in my mouth. Ah, ah well, whatever. It'll be fine. Anyway. Let us carry on with what we were doing. I believe we had just got to Dragonfall Sewers. Not a huge fan of this map. It's not necessarily the map's fault. I don't know why, I'm just not a fan of it. It's probably due to the fact that I always fall down and kill myself into the pits of death and destruction, as usual. It's one of my things, it's fine. I am basically this guy. That's me. Always falling in. That's all of the players I play with just looking at me going, what the fuck are you doing? That's basically it. So anyway, yes, sorry I have not been here over the past, this last week. It's been a bit of a difficult week for me this week, but, you know, whatever, it's fine. I'm back now, and that's the main thing. Back update for all of those who care. I will be getting acupuncture to hopefully fix my back. That will be starting on the 11th of this month, so that will be interesting. I've never actually had acupuncture before, so it will definitely be an experience and one I am looking forward to. It's one of those things I've always been quite curious about, so when they said I could have acupuncture as one of my treatment options, yeah, I jumped on it and thought, you know what? Sure, we'll try it. What's the worst that could happen apart from, you know, the usual worst that could happen with any kind of medical issues? But yeah, that should be good fun. So I'm looking forward to that. Which is something I didn't think I would say about a treatment option. But, you know, sure, sounds good. So, what else has been going on? Not a lot, really. Been a bit strange on the old, the old medicine front this week. It's not been great. Don't know why, it's just one of those things. Aoma did remind me in the comments down below, thank you very much, not to forget about the free tower from the Lavamancer. It does nothing at this level, apart from give you mana when it gets to 100% charge. It'll have a little orb floating above it, which gives you mana. But when you upgrade it once, it creates like a nice fire field around it, which is awesome. Especially if you combine it with one of those. So that's what we're going to be doing. We're going to be trying that out. So these will... That's the little mana orb. So this will oil the enemies and then this will set them on fire. Which will be fun. Will be good fun. So we're definitely going to be trying that out. And enjoying that. Unfortunately you can only have two of them. So that's only going to be up there. Again, it's limited to how many Lavamancers you have. Not how many Lavamancers are on the map, so in theory you could have one every single lane if you had enough Lavamancers. So that's up to you. Why did I go there? Down here, we're going to have a more conventional setup, I think. It's just going to be one of these. With one of these. And eventually a buff beam, but not quite yet. Now, I have had a few comments asking about multiplayer and people playing with me and various stuff like that. I don't think I'm going to be doing that on this save. I kind of saved the multiplayer and stuff for on live streams. So if that's something you're interested in, I will let you know when I'm starting up my live streams again, and you can come to twitch.tv/darkpython and join us there for a lovely little live stream. We always have a lot of good fun, and yeah, we just play some games, and that's about it, really. So, if multiplayer is something you guys are interested in, that's where it happens most of the time, so keep that in mind. Right, that's those two lanes set up. Wait, have I forgotten an entire lane? No, that's that lane. Okay, cool. Ugh, this is why this one... I don't know why, it just bloody confuses me. It really does. Everyone will be getting a reflect beam, because dragons suck, as do javelin throwers. They just suck. I hate them. I hate them almost as much as dark elf warriors. Nothing will ever beat my hate of Sharken, but... Well, we'll see when they bring out more mobs, won't we? Okay, so that lane's fine, that lane's fine. That lane's good. We've got 70 DU left. These two lanes are going to need the most help to start with. What are we missing? Oh, I know what I'm missing. You turnip. I know exactly what I'm missing. Anyone else guessed it yet? That's right. I am missing the Volcano of Fun and Destruction. Also missing a valid place to pop it. You know, I'm really thinking up here. If I pop it here... You know, that's going to have a pretty good range on it, I would imagine, because for some reason... It doesn't show you the range. Thank you for that one, Trendy. That is a huge help. Yeah, I'm guessing it's got a pretty good range on her. She'll be fine there, she'll be fine there. So, I think we will help out on the Gun Witch for a while and start shooting. So, how has everyone been enjoying this week? Have you been playing lots of Dungeon Defenders? Anything... interesting that you wish to share with everyone? Let me know down below if there's any topics you want me to talk about on these videos, whether it be Dungeon Defenders related or various other things. That's absolutely fine. I feel these are more going to be sort of, I know, more of a like vlog, if you will, than a this is how you play this game. Yeah, so, wait, what? Oh, frickin' Wyverns. God damn it. Okay. Happy days. Well, that's something we're going to need to sort out pretty quickly. I completely forgot about those bastards. Right, okay. What can we do for their defense? Well, we're definitely going to have snaky people, I guess. It's always fun knocking these guys off into oblivion. I must admit, I haven't been falling off as much recently, and that's mainly due to the fact that this woman can fly. Which is really nice. Ooh, hello there. Clean sweep and dead eye. Not now. I'm looking at loot. It's only a little bit more and I do lose the hero damage, so I'm not actually going to go with that. Okay, so we need to find something to deal with these flying bastards. Not now. Okay, fine. I'll do it now. You are going for crit and this... Also speed. We'll actually get your speed up fairly high. There we go. 40, 50, 40. Seems good. You are going to be... 60, and then all into speed. You are going to start getting that in there, and... There you go. Lovely jubbly. Now. Oh, wait. There's one more, isn't there? The gun which... Lovely. Right. Yeah, I think we're just gonna... Not those snakes. These snakes. I'm just gonna use these for a little while. And this one will actually have the free tower as well. We'll pop that one over here. Why not? does a little bit extra damage and stuff. It's not a great tower, but it's something. I'm so used to the double jump now that it's weird whenever I go onto a different character. I keep on trying to press spacebar twice and it's just not doing anything, which is very upsetting. Now, these guys didn't have buff beams yet. I want them to have buff beams. Yep. I want every lane to have a buff beam, really. They're not vital, but they are useful. So we're definitely going to be using those. Especially if this snake is our air defense. When really it's more of a slowdown machine as opposed to an air defense. So yeah, that's going to be interesting. And we don't have enough DU for a buff beam, unfortunately. I know it says 30 DU, but that's 30 DU per node to start with. And then it goes down to, I believe, 20. So yeah, it will not let us do it. I hate that it doesn't tell you that. It's very, very annoying. So it looks like this lane is going to have to be babysat somewhat. Like, we might be able to get one of those. Yeah, we can get a one lane of those. So that's what we'll go with. We're going to upgrade these. As you can see, that's the radius of the damage that it does. Also not really explained very well. The tooltips do leave a lot to be desired in Dungeon Defenders still, but it's definitely something they can work on, so I am willing to forgive them for now. They have precisely one patch to fix it, or else... I don't mean that, don't worry. I'm not going to be that mean. Eh, I could, but I'm not going to. So yeah, we're primarily going to be on flying enemy defense by the looks of it. Now, I think the only flyers go towards the cores. So we the sub-cores. So that's actually pretty good for us. Actually, what we do want to do, we want to be on the Mystic for a while, don't we? Because we're trying to get her sorted out, which means flying enemies could be a problem. Ooh, actually. They're being taken care of quite well at the moment. Yeah, they're not going too badly at the moment, actually. I think we might have it down for the flying enemies, you know? I think we might be alright, guys. I think we might be alright. It'll be alright on the bulls. Never mind. It won't be alright on the knight. I regret to inform you that this was wrong. And we will very much not be alright on the knight. It'll be okay, it'll be a little bit of damage on the cores, but there's no bonus XP, I don't believe, anymore for finishing without any damage on the cores or anything like that. So, it's nothing too bad. There we go, we got our super snake. So now we can run super fast. We are Super Saiyan Snake Lady, which is always good fun. Right, come here, you. Right, let's just start upgrading everything, really, because everything does damage here. Including the reflect walls. They do a lot of damage. They're not terrible. Hero damage, hero crit, focus fire, and 360 no scope. Go on then. Go on then! Why the heck not? That seems like a jolly good idea to me. And if I could find the right character, that would be a better idea. It's already at max, that's fine. These two upgraded so they attack a little bit quicker. Yeah, it's all going well so far. Like I said, I will just be doing this map probably only the once. I'm not a huge fan of it. Not really sure why, like I said, it's just one of those things, you know. Sometimes you don't like maps. What can I say? It's no one's fault. I'm just going to slap people with a bit of a snake. We haven't found a single weapon for this character yet. I was looking through earlier on, we haven't found a single one yet for her. It's very annoying. Not a good one anyway, I mean, we might as well grab this one, but... yeah, they've all been kind of a bit naff, really. which isn't great, but never mind. Let's just smash these guys into oblivion. I do have to be careful because they might get flung down onto that little area down there, but it won't matter too much because then the other towers will destroy them. Ooh, what have we got here? More blues? Ooh, hello. That's for the Sand Viper. That's excellent. That's power defense health. Yeah. Yeah, that's great. Don't mind if I do. Yeah, so just get slapped with a snake. Knock him off, knock him off, knock him off. Damn it! God damn, I can't reach. I want to knock him off. Come on, bugger off. There you go.
Into oblivion.
See, it's going much better now. Once we get everything upgraded and stuff, you know, it starts to go much, much better. We are going to have problems in the later stages of the game, and I'm not sure how I'm going to fix those problems yet. So if anyone has any ideas on how we can fix the issue of flying enemies in the later stages of the game, I'm all ears, because at the moment, I have no idea. I have absolutely no idea. I think it's going to be a pretty big problem for us. It's going to stop us from doing various things, like the incursion, the Wyvern Den incursion. That one's going to be practically impossible, I think, for us at the moment. So yeah, we're going to have to be careful of that, definitely. That is definitely something that we're going to need to look out for. Wait, can I have more than one of these, or... No, yeah, it just moves that one around, doesn't it, I believe. Oh, hello there. Nice little bit of lag. Yeah, it's not been a great week for games and things in general, actually, this week. Obviously, there was the big DDoS attack, I believe that was this week, that happened earlier in the week, which absolutely sucked. That knocked everything out for quite some time, at least it did in the UK, anyway. A good 12-15 hours it was that I wasn't able to play on the PS4, YouTube, nothing. It really did suck. Not the best in the world, that's for sure. Which is a bit of a shame. Oh, we haven't upgraded this at all. That's incredibly dumb of us. It's like our main damage. Go away, witch. Now, I was planning on doing the Halloween maps, but I decided against it because I'd have to use my main characters, and I thought, you know what, we'll get there in time. It won't be a problem. We don't need to be all Halloween-y like everyone else is. It might be a little bit refreshing for people to have a video that isn't all about Halloween. Don't worry, I'm not sat here dressed up in like a vampire outfit or anything. So, nothing to fear there. I'm just sat here in normal clothes like a normal person with a fractured back. As you do. Oh god, it's crystal beasts they're introducing. Okay. Where is it? Where is it? Oh, no, that's the wrong button. There it is. Nope, nope, I don't... Don't press tab, guys. Don't press tab. Nope, nope. Oh my goodness, now I've moved that. You know what? Fine, I'll pop it. Damn it. What am I doing with my life? I'll pop it there. Help me kill this guy. This would be much easier if I actually had a good weapon for this character. What's gone down? We've... 60 DU is missing. What on earth went down? Still got everything here. Yeah, still everything there. Right, okay, what about over here? Still appear to have everything over here. We got the beam, that and that. Wait, did that have a buff beam? I don't think it did. What about over here? Buff beam's still there, that's still there. That's still there. What on earth went... Ah, the buff beam over here went down. How? Nothing else went down over here. How did the buff beam go down? It doesn't matter, it's the last wave, but... Curiouser and curiouser. Deeper into the rabbit hole. Ooh, purple! Hello there. How are you doing? Hello, you beauty! Aren't you just the prettiest, eh? There you go. What's it gonna be? Who's it gonna be for? It's for my DPS character, unfortunately. Not the best outcome, but you know, it's alright. That is also for you, but a bit redundant considering we literally just got a purple. Torpedo range and secondary heat, that is perfect. Not the secondary heat, but the fact it's those stats. Because that is perfect for our lovely little EV over here. And there we are. It's all going well. Not too bad at all. You know what? I'll give you an extra long one today. We'll do another map. We'll go on to the next map and see what it is, yeah? How about that? A bit of a Halloween treat, if you will. As for what's your trick going to be, well, the trick was the fact that you've had no other videos for the entire week. And I am sorry about that. But it's a little bit hectic over here at the moment with me and everyone else doing everything and blah blah blah. You don't want to hear it. It's fine. But yeah, it's fun to be back, and I do enjoy doing this, and I hope you have all enjoyed the transition of me coming back. Anyway, let's play some Dungeon Defenders. Let's defend some dungeons, if there were any dungeons to defend in this game. That still really annoys me. I don't know why. Just, there's like hardly any dungeons in this game. Drives me crazy. Now, you will see me turtle in this map. That's because I really like this map for turtling. It's just one of those maps that's really easy to turtle on. And to be honest, it's pretty damn satisfying as well. Like, it's a satisfying turtle map. It really is. So, we're going to be doing lots of things here. Now, another thing it doesn't tell you is... these get cheaper after the first one, so this, if you were thinking, it would be 40, 80, 120, and 160 for that, yeah? Nope. Much less. As you would have seen if I paid attention to the DU number, but if you rewind it back quickly, you'll see that that did not cost us 160. So, it gets cheaper the longer they are. So if you can do a big line like that, it benefits you. I have tested it out on numerous occasions. It is superior. So trust me on that one. Now we are going to need some pretty heavy flying defense here, which worries me a great deal because flying is not our friends in this on that at the moment for us. Now I will say, you know what, I'm going to say bugger off to you, and we're going to pop you up here, because that's actually a pretty good place for it. I didn't actually think about that before, but it's a pretty good place for it. And then we're going to get some snacks and stuff right beside it, and these will actually probably go a little bit further than I think they will. Yeah, they actually do get to the walls as well, so that's really nice. So we're going to do 4 in total. Yep, like there, and one more over here, which will get over... oh, not quite over to that wall. That's a shame. But it'll be fine. This is for our flying defense and also extra DPS down below. Now this is a pretty difficult map, all in all. It's not one that's very high on the intuition scale, you know, it's... I don't know, it's just something about this map is... I always find people complain about this map, you know, it being very, very difficult and stuff like that. So hopefully, I mean, this setup is not going to be the best by any means, and I'm getting lots of lag tonight. Not enough mana. Ah, yes, mana. Shit. Oh dear. Okay, so we're going to be on the Gun Witch the first wave. I would not recommend this as a build. Do not do this as your build. Please. Just don't. It's not worth your effort. This is basically going to be an awful lot of me shooting things for this first wave. That's fine, I want that to die. It's fine, that one can also die. By the way, it's not best if you let things die. The XP gain you get from not letting the subcores die, and the XP gain you get from the extra enemies, you get less from the extra enemies, basically. So it is best, if you're going for XP, to save all the subcores. But in terms of speed and just my sanity, I don't know, I just really like this map when it's done like this. It's just a nice map to turtle on, you know? Just sometimes you need a good turtle in your life, and this is that for me. I don't know, I just enjoy it. It's fine, it's all good. It's all good. Oh my goodness, that's a great big fireball. I can't wait to see how much damage that fireball does late game. That's going to be a fun one. What are you though? Defense power, defense crit. Hello there. Go on then. If you insist. I mean, everything is dying and I've got no DPS out. Like, I've got this one volcano and a couple of snakes. And everything's just getting murdered. It helps that this thing can go through walls. I hope they never fix that, to be perfectly honest, but they probably will now that I pointed it out in a video that Ison watches every now and again, so I'll try not to point it out too much, and hopefully he won't watch this video. Oh god. I really hope he doesn't. Right, let's not upgrade stuff yet. We don't technically need more defences, but we're going to get more defences. They're going to go on the side lanes, because the side lanes, I find, tend to be the most tricky to hold. And this one is going to go right here. And I kind of want an oil here. And you know what? We'll just pop the oil like right here. And then we'll just buff those up. There's no way in hell I'm going to get to buff it all, so I'll just buff the buff beam. Buff the buff beam, yeah. Yeah, that's how you do it, Dark. You idiot. I will buff the proton beam and the wall and the reflect. That seems like a pretty good cause to me. They're always good ones to do it on. Same with here. That's the wrong way around. We want it this way. Not that it matters much, but now if we can only do two buff beams, which I'm starting to think might be the case, because it is the case with my proper build that I do on this map. It is the case that I can only get away with two buff beams, one on either side. Yeah, it is. Okay, so middle lanes, go. Middle lanes are not particularly difficult, and they're the easiest ones for you to add DPS onto just by standing back and shooting, so I tend to bulk up the sides and then just sort of shoot the hell out of the mid lane. It's a little bit of fun as well. You gotta bear that in mind when you're playing this game, you know? Don't just do builds because they're the best. If they're not fun, don't do them. I mean, in the long run, you're going to be playing this game for quite a few hundred hours. So you can worry about what's optimal later on, you know? Just for now, just enjoy it. Enjoy yourself. You know, mess around with some builds. Be silly. That kind of stuff. Don't worry about what's optimal and who should I be doing this. People have told me that these towers are bad, blah, 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 blah. Who cares? If it makes you happy, do it. There's a general life lesson as well. If something makes you happy, just do it as long as it doesn't hurt other people, and, you know, it's all within the law and kosher kind of thing. Yeah, that was a weird rant to go on, but it's all good. We're going to go and shoot some more orcs and stuff for Halloween. How many people here have watched Brooklyn Nine-Nine? I hope a lot of you. It's an incredibly good show. It is on Netflix if you have that. I would highly recommend it. Season 1 and 2 are currently on Netflix, and yeah, very, very good show. The Halloween episodes especially are just so well done. Us in, me, my other half, and our flatmate must have watched series 1 and 2 about, I don't know, 15 to 20 times now. It's just one of those things that you can have in the background. It's a little bit of mindless humour, and yeah, it's just good fun. So I would highly recommend that. I would also highly recommend Jessica Jones, but that's one that's a little bit darker, but highly, highly suggest it. Incredible show. Really thoroughly enjoyed it. I haven't actually watched Luke Cage yet, so I don't know what everyone's been thinking about that, but haven't really heard much about it, which is sometimes good and sometimes not. Yeah, haven't watched that one yet, but I am looking forward to it. Definitely looking forward to it. Ooh, do we have some more booties for our witchy? Yes, yes we do. Alright, go on then. Why the hell not? This is going well. This is a good day. Getting some good loot on this map. This has always been a good map for loot, you know. We are going to pop that on this character, definitely. Yeah, this has always been a fun map for loot. It's one I farm a lot on my main characters on the actual event map, which I can't remember the name of now because I'm a terrible person and I've never played this game, apparently. Oh god, what's it called? The Gold Rush one. Where you have the Goblin King there and you have to go around and get all the golden nuggets. That one. I thoroughly enjoy that one. It's quick. It's about the speed I want the maps to be. It takes roughly, I think the quickest time we got it down to was 9.5 minutes. That was with the four people and all just absolutely on the ball. But it was fun, and you know, that's what I kind of want from this game. Is I want a game that's quick to farm, you know, not ones that take half an hour, 40 minutes to get through, and you know, stuff like that. I don't enjoy that. I shouldn't say I don't enjoy it, because I do enjoy it. It's just, it's difficult to spend that much time on one map that you're not even sure you're going to get any good loot, which it was my biggest problem with DD1 actually. Like, you would spend hours and hours and hours on one map and you may not actually get any good loot from it. Like, you'd be running King's Game or Tavern Defense and, you know, you'd be on there for about 2 hours and stuff, and then when you go through the loot, it's like, well, I got one upgrade in 2.5 hours. That's not fun for me, you know. As a guy who can't really stay at the computer at the moment for more than 2 to 3 hours kind of thing, I like my games to have a certain quickness about it. You know, I don't want to spend 2 hours on a map and get no progress. That's why games like Gonna, which I did a video for earlier in the week, and stuff like that, are very fun for me because they are quick. You know, you can spend an hour on it and feel like you progressed. Whereas games like, unfortunately, Dungeon Defenders, and even like the new Civ 6, I don't have it, but it's one of those games where if you're not on it for ages, you don't really feel the progress. So yeah, it's difficult for me at the moment. It is very difficult. It's strange having sort of seeing games from this point of view. You don't really think about it too much when you can spend 8 hours on the computer without any problems. But when it comes to not being able to do that, suddenly then it's sort of a bit weirder, you know? it's a little bit more difficult then. Wow, this volcano's done so much work. It has been absolutely annihilating people. I haven't even really been upgrading anything either. I think it's still tier 1. Oh, Jesus. It's superb. Right, let's upgrade this buff beam. Yeah, it is still tier 1 and all. Let's max it out. Let's also max out this buff beam. Because why the hell not? Chuck this one of love and all. Looks like we're going to need to upgrade our reflect walls a little bit, give them some loving, get our walls up a little bit, give them some more speed. Yeah, so far this has been going really well. Like, I knew the volcano was doing work. I didn't realise how much. Like, holy crap, I wasn't expecting it to have literally carried us this entire time. I'm starting to think we might be able to make something work with this volcano long term, you know. I sort of just used it as a little bit of a joke thing to start off with. Like, I knew it was going to be good. Like I said, I didn't realise it was going to be this good. Like, this is just beyond expectation for me, really. Which is nice, you know. It's nice to be pleasantly surprised like that sometimes. We're just going to do some more upgrading. Nope. Oh, you got barbecued, my friend. Goodbye. Goodbye. Now, these proton beams will get absolutely ludicrous very soon. As soon as I get the passive, which gives them a chance to freeze, it's basically GG for the game. Any non-flying enemies will just be killed. Because these attack so fast, they're attacking every 0.07 seconds. No, sorry, 0.3 seconds. That's very quick, which means even though it's only something like a 3% chance, that 3% chance is being propped like 4 times a second. And, you know, that adds up pretty quick. And they walk pretty slowly, so by the time they get from here to here, they're probably frozen. By the time they get from here to here, they're almost definitely dead. So even though something is a low percent chance, don't think it's terrible, you know? It's probably not. Just take into account how many times that chance is going to be proccing per second, and then you start to see the real value. It's the same with a lot of other games where it's like, oh, you know, 1% chance to do this, but it's 1% chance on hit, and if you're using a lot of quick attacks, that's when you can really, you know, go for broke on that certain passive. You'll see that a lot when I start playing Grim Dawn. That will be coming to the channel at some point, hopefully fairly soon. I want to do a playthrough of that. And yeah, you'll see that come into effect, because there's a lot of on-hit proc effects and various things like that. And they end up for making just astounding builds that just destroy everything in their way. So hopefully you end up seeing the power of on-hit proc effects. Because a lot of people just think they're a gimmick and they're kind of useless. They're definitely not. They're really not. Oh goody, kobold gliders. The worst things known to mankind. Because even though I'm going to shoot this guy, he's just going to dive bomb when he gets down to a certain HP. I'm hoping he will dive bomb me. Which is why I'm trying to hit him so much. But he didn't, he dive bombed something and it did basically no damage by the looks of it, so who cares. Right, where's the next one? Oh, next one? No, next 10. Yes. My god, that's so many of them. If they all go into the core, it's GG pretty much, by the way. Yeah, they did, like, no damage. They did
They're pathetic.
They do nothing. That's the problem I find with the kobolds. They either wreck you completely on, like, Nightmare 4, or they do nothing at all. Never be afraid of an Explodinator. If you see the boss Explodinator, don't be afraid of it. It does like 150 damage per proc of its little dynamites. It will kill you off. It won't kill anything else. It won't kill your wall. It won't kill anything substantial. Like, it might take down... No, I can't think of anything it'll take down. Maybe it'll take down one of the apprentice flamethrower towers or something, because they're very low health. But obviously they can't be targeted, but Explodinator doesn't need to target necessarily. So that's always something to keep in mind. Sorry, I thought someone came in, but apparently no. I'm just hearing things. Ooh, it's spooky on Halloween. Lots of noises around the house. So what does everyone get up to for Halloween? Let me know in the comments below. It's something I'd be interested in hearing, because, like I said, in the UK, we get up to nothing. We basically just treat it like another day. There are fireworks that go off around. Kids occasionally go around houses and knock on doors, but I found that was more something that happened in the where I used to live, down south. Haven't seen it happen at all up in Manchester. Like, just hasn't happened up here. So, yeah, it's just one of those things, I don't know. Let me know in the comments below. But for now, that is going to be it for me today on Dungeon Defenders. I hope you have all enjoyed. I will be back, hopefully, tomorrow with some more Dungeon Defenders content. And we will see if we can complete this campaign. And once we complete the campaign, we'll go on from there and start doing incursions and all sorts of other wonderful things that are in this game. So, I hope you've all enjoyed yourselves. I hope you have a wonderful day, and I will catch you all tomorrow. Have a good one. Goodbye, everyone.